We deployed 60,000 soldiers to combat this year alone, fighting ISIS, the Taliban, and many other radical terrorist groups. We've rapidly responded to a variety of exercises in Asia and Europe, Central and South America, Africa, to assure our partners and friends, and while we deter our adversaries.
This mission, in my view, has one common thread, and that thread is readiness.
Freedom is not free. It takes sacrifice, it takes lives. Most of all, it takes a trained and ready United States military.
It's important because we never know when we'll be called to actually do this in real life situations.
Do the tasks, knock it out.
We will and must find the best robotics, the newest technologies, and ensure that the best logistics and transportation methods are available to our soldier so they always have the advantage on the battlefield.
We are providing you with the best equipment possible. I can tell you that.
In the future, we have to continue to recruit and retain the very best talent from future generations.
There's nothing we enjoy more than coming out in the field to where we learn more than anything we could possibly learn in the Pentagon. But I want them to know how much their leadership appreciates what they're doing.
You're doing, with your lives, the noblest thing that you can do, which is to protect our people and make a better world for our children.
The Army's come a long way when it comes to family support for our military, and I'm very proud of what they're doing today for the families.
Understand that there are people out there that care about you and, you know, really want to look out for you, and make sure you connect with those people who want to be there for you.
So as we look to the future, it's incumbent that we maintain our capabilities and our capacity as a military.
We will all look back after victory and remember who participated in the fight.
So we're sending a message. If you target Americans, you will have no safe haven. We will find you and we will defend our nation.
All Americans are created equal and fair in this country, and I'm willing to die for it, and so are you.